It's said that spirits and paranormal entities like to haunt children the most because they're the most approachable and they're the most susceptible to things like possession. Spirits like children because they're easy to entice and they're so innocent. In today's video, we'll count down the 10 scariest ghost sightings that were made by children. Ready to join the finest squad? Then make sure to subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss any of our interesting videos ever again. That being said, let's begin! Blair sees a ghost. This is a good example of parents not taking their children seriously when they say they've seen a ghost. Now, we know it's a small child that can barely talk, and they may just be saying that or making something up, but during a camera recording, the child Blair suddenly turns into the darkness and asks a question about the ghost. Jokingly, the parents say something along the lines of the child's father taking care of the ghost. This indicates that this isn't the first time the child has brought up the idea of a ghost being in their house. This is something they should probably take seriously, because children can form bonds with ghosts in ways that we can't. This is why they're able to talk to them and see them when we sometimes can't and need special equipment to do so. Nothing else comes of the video, and they keep recording for a short time longer, but we have to assume that this isn't the last time that Blair's gonna see the ghost, nor will it be the last time that the parents are probably laughing at their kid for bringing up the ghost. Baby talks to ghosts. This is another great example of spirits reaching out to kids for conversation. Children are so much more susceptible to being able to talk to and see spirits than we give them credit for. And when things like this happen, parents often ignore it and don't put the attention towards it that it deserves. In this particular incident, we have a family that's doing some vlog recording. During one part of the vlog, they put their kid inside of the dining room while the mother's doing some cleaning around the house and getting things ready. At this point, we see the mother walk out of the room and, shortly after, we see the kid turn his attention towards someone who's standing in the corner. However, we can see the reflection of the kid on the table, and we can't see a reflection of anyone else. There's also a mirror hanging up behind the child, but we can't see any reflection in there either. The child is talking to someone, having an incoherent conversation. The mother walks back in briefly, and the conversation starts to die down to a halt, as if the ghost is no longer there. Baby girl sees spirit. This video starts out rather refreshing and brings a smile to your face. What's more of a reason to smile than a child's laughter? The parents are filming the child from a staircase and they're speaking to their child. We can only assume she hasn't been walking for very long. However, things start to turn a little dark as her laughter starts to become silent and she begins to follow something with her eyes, but we can't quite see what's going on. She becomes rather startled and starts looking around as if she's just seen something horrific. The laughter completely stops, and then she just walks into the other room as if she's following something and talking to it. The parents don't really seem too concerned with what's going on because the first thought in their mind isn't that their child just saw a ghost. Most parents more than likely think that children are just random, and there's not a lot of rational thought that goes into the things that they do. Do you think this child was just starting to get bored? Or do you think her head movements and uneasiness suggested that there was a ghost in the room? 2-year-old sees ghost. This person is filming their daughter who has walked up to the door and she seems rather curious about something, but she's not speaking. Not every child is talkative. Some are rather shy and prefer not to talk that much, so that doesn't mean anything. However, it's not her silence that's concerning, it's the fact that she seems to be staring at something in the room. She seems to have her eyes rather focused on whatever is in the room, and she's not even looking at her mother who's filming her. Now, some people think that she could have just been looking at a TV, or she could have been looking at something distracting in the room, and this doesn't really suggest that she was looking at a ghost. However, there was no TV in the direction she was looking, or any kind of distraction. The mother also noted that she refused to walk into the room, which was rather strange and unusual for the child. Nothing is revealed in the video, but the child clearly saw something that scared her from entering the room, and will probably never know what it was. Baby sees ghost. We see a rather heartfelt video at the beginning of this video. We see a father playing with his child, and he's pretending to eat food while playing with a toy. The child appears to be having a good time and he's laughing along with the father. For a second though, the child turns his attention towards the camera because it does have a rather bright light on the front of the camera, so we can see how it's kind of distracting. This isn't the most disturbing part, it's what comes after the child looks at the camera. We can see in view of the camera that a very odd-looking orb flies by the child, but no one else seems to notice. The person filming and the father seem to be completely oblivious to the orb as if they can't even see it. Then, the child's laughter turns to silence, and they become quite concerned with whatever's happening. They look to their right where there's no one, and they just start staring at nothing. It's clear that something is off view of the camera, and something could possibly be talking to the child. Could it be a spirit, or could there be some kind of distraction? Perhaps there could be a simpler explanation. Toddler sees ghost. This is a far more interesting video because we see a toddler is staring at the ceiling, and this is why the mother started to film the interaction. The father sitting in the background on a computer and probably thinks the child's just making things up with an extensive imagination. He jokingly tells the child to ask the ghost what their name is, but the ghost seems to be moving around the house as the child follows it. She stares at the ceiling, goes into the hallway, and comes back into the room. She doesn't say much, as she can't really talk well yet. The mother keeps trying to ask the child questions, but she doesn't really respond. The ghost seems to stick around in the room, moving around the ceiling, and the mother at one point even says that it's starting to creep her out. The father doesn't really seem invested into what's going on, and maybe he doesn't really believe that the child is actually seeing anything, but maybe she's just distracted by the ceiling for other reasons. Baby sees ghost of a man on the stairs. Children have very vivid imaginations, which is what makes it hard to figure out which of these videos are authentic and which ones aren't. However, not a lot of these children are able to talk fluently, so then we have this one. We see the video start out filming a child who's coloring in a coloring book. The mother's trying to ask the child where she saw the man. We assume that the child is saying that they saw a man standing in the stairwell. In the room, there's a set of stairs that goes upwards, and there's a corner, indicating that it's a spiral staircase. The child points towards the staircase, telling her mother that there's a man that was standing in the staircase. However, when the camera points towards the stairs, there's obviously not a man standing there at the time of filming, so the mother doesn't quite believe the child. However, the mother is filming the incident, so that tells us this isn't the first time this has been brought up. It's very possible that there could be someone squatting inside the house, and this is something that's actually happened before to other people. Little girl talking to a ghost. At the start of this video, we see a child sitting down for some breakfast, and the mother presumably is filming the child. We can't understand what they're saying, and the subtitles aren't in English either, so we'll have to go by what we can see. We see the child talking to the mother for a while, trying to explain what was happening, but the mother doesn't quite see what's going on. Then, the mother starts to pan the camera around the entire house just to show that there's nothing there. However, something really disturbing happens in the video footage. Once the footage was reviewed, you can see that when she pans the camera around to the mirror in the corner of the room, there is clearly a man standing in the mirror, but he's not in the room. The child was, in fact, talking to a spirit. Upon reviewing the footage, we don't know what the mother did or what came of this, but we can only assume they probably moved out of there and found somewhere else to live. Hopefully somewhere without a ghost living in their mirror. Children seeing ghosts. If you have a dog or a cat, do you remember the reaction they had the first time they saw a mirror? They got a little too excited and they run around the mirror trying to find the animal they think they're talking to. The same concept applies when a child sees a ghost in the mirror. In this video, we see a child running around and it appears the child is talking to someone in the room. A parent is filming the encounter between the child as they run back and forth like a lost puppy. The child occasionally tries to touch the spirit and ends up meeting the wall instead. There are a couple of possibilities here. The child might just be bored and trying to keep himself from falling asleep. This is something that children do all the time to stay awake. Children generally don't like going to bed. Or the child could actually be playing hide and seek with a friendly spirit. Baby pushed over by ghost. Ghosts in general are usually pretty friendly. You don't hear about a lot of ghosts doing any kind of harm to children or even touching babies. but in the very rare occasion, sometimes ghosts can be jealous of their youth, or they can just be vengeful spirits. However, ghosts that cause harm are more likely poltergeists and not actually ghosts. In this video, we have a baby dancing and laughing like a baby does. The baby's just having some fun and not bothering anyone. The baby doesn't appear to be talking to a ghost or paying any attention to a ghost in the room. This might be why what happens next happens. Perhaps the spirit in the room felt neglected and wanted some attention, but the baby wasn't giving the spirit the attention that it wanted. What happens next is kind of puzzling. The baby, all of a sudden, is pushed down to the ground backwards, and the baby didn't trip over their own feet. It looks like the baby was actually pushed down with force. Perhaps there's a more simplistic explanation, though, and we're looking too far into it. Do you think there are ghosts and spirits that haunt children because they're easier to haunt? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.